Welcome to a training video on TSI Certifier Flow Analyzers. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to connect the Certifier Plus Flow Analyzer to a ventilator for testing. The high flow module is used for testing ventilators and is capable of testing any type or model of ventilator. Connect the high flow module to the interface module using the coiled cable, and then press the power button to turn the instrument on. Power can be supplied to the Certifier Plus using the AC power adapter or from its internal battery. After the instrument boots, wait 1 minute for the sensors to warm up before taking measurements. Uncap the ends of the flow module and connect the filter to the inlet. There's an arrow printed on the front of the flow module to indicate the forward direction of flow. To protect your Certifier flow analyzer, it's important to always operate with a filter upstream of the flow module and to cap the ends when not in use. Install the high flow module into the test circuit with the Y fitting upstream or on the inlet side of the flow module. This corrugated tubing is used to carry inspiratory and expiratory flows from the ventilator and then back to the ventilator. A test lung will be connected to the outlet of the flow module. For a bidirectional test setup, the Y fitting needs to be placed before the flow module so that the inspiratory flows come from the ventilator through the Certifier into the test lung and then back through the Certifier as expiratory flows, which then return to the ventilator. For a unidirectional test setup, this Y fitting would be placed after the flow module, between the flow module and the test lung. With this test setup, only the inspiratory flows would be measured by the Certifier, and the expiratory flows would be diverted from passing through the Certifier instead and would vent to the atmosphere. To connect the low pressure measurement to the test circuit, attach the airway adapter to the outlet of the flow module and then connect a piece of tubing from the airway adapter to the positive pressure port on the flow module. Low pressure measures the difference in pressure between the positive and negative ports. When used with a test lung, we recommend that the low pressure adapter be placed on the outlet of the flow module, as this will help condition the flows that are coming back from the test lung through the Certifier. The oxygen sensor is used to measure the real-time oxygen concentration of gas flowing through the sensor, flowing through the Certifier. The oxygen sensor works with the high flow module and it can be connected or disconnected at any time without disrupting the operation of the Certifier. To connect the oxygen sensor, screw the sensor cell into the airway coupling and attach the coupling to the test circuit. And then connect the cable from the oxygen sensor to the barrel jack located on top of the flow module. The oxygen sensor could be installed in the circuit after the flow module, as shown here, or it could be installed before the flow module between the Y fitting and the filter. To complete the test circuit, we will connect the test lung downstream of the flow module. The test lung simulates a patient's breathing, and there are a variety of different types and sizes of test lungs that are used when testing ventilators. For our demonstration, we're using a 1 liter test lung. After the circuit is set up, you would then configure the test parameters on the Certifier's touchscreen interface. These test parameters are specified by the ventilator manufacturer in their service manual. Learn more about operating the Certifier touchscreen in other TSI videos. Before you start testing, it's recommended to zero the low pressure transducer to ensure the most accurate readings. To zero the pressure transducers, disconnect any tubing from the pressure ports located on the flow module and then press the zero button that's on the touchscreen interface. If using an oxygen sensor, it's recommended that you calibrate it before testing. The oxygen sensor can be calibrated with either a 1-point air-only calibration or a 2-point air and oxygen calibration. With the oxygen sensor connected to the high flow module, select oxygen sensor in the settings of the Certifier interface, and the on-screen prompts will take you step by step through the calibration process. You are now ready to begin your ventilator testing. That's it for today. Follow me for more tips.